What do you associate with the Middle Ages? A solemn, gloomy epoch, averse to science and human progress. Better forgotten about? Which image do you see in front of your mind's eye when I evoke this supposedly somber chapter of history? But what if I told you that what we traditionally refer to as the Middle Ages were centuries brimming with investigating and understanding our world and changing it for the better? The foundation of universities, temples of worship on a magnificent scale, trade exchange, international law, and elaborate philosophies. All these were achieved between roughly 500 and 1500. And so much remains to be discovered from the medieval era, which is not researched yet. I want to explore one of these unresearched areas, which even has the potential to influence neuroscience today. We are talking hence of neuro-medievalism. This term, neuro-medievalism, is not new. There are some researchers who have hinted at the possibility for neuroscience to be inspired by medieval concepts. The work of Mary Carruthers on memory gets often cited, rightly so. Still, what we know about how medieval minds thought about the brain is limited to discussions in the discipline of medieval studies.
What?
To such an extent that the entry on mental images in the Stanford Encyclopedia of Philosophy eclipses the entire medieval period altogether. Descartes follows Aristotle here.
What?
The impression is thus easily created that nothing new or innovative was brought by in those nearly 2,000 years.
What?
I aim to bring medieval ideas to the table and make them fruitful for how people research and speak about mental images today. The first steps into this truly cross-fertilizing way of collaborating were taken when in June 2022, I organized a workshop with neuropsychologists and medievalists to talk about our common interests in the human brain. Our discussions created thirst for more, interdisciplinary conversation, but also first clinical trials. This breakthrough towards neuromedievalism is so promising because it will bring back into awareness medieval ideas for mental imagery in a most meaningful way, that is, in dialogue with those who research it today.